The sky has always been a battlefield, a vast, invisible frontier where power is contested, and nations rise or fall. In this ceaseless struggle, one name has begun to resonate with a quiet intensity, the HQ-22. Born from the ingenuity of China's military-industrial complex, this surface-to-air missile system stands as a sentinel in an age of uncertainty. It's not merely a weapon, it's a declaration, a technological marvel crafted to shield a nation and challenge its rivals. Welcome to an odyssey through the heart of modern air defense. We'll unravel the story of the HQ-22, its origins, rooted in Cold War echoes, its engineering feats that defy the odds, and its role in a world where control of the skies dictates destiny. What secrets lie within its sleek missiles and humming radars? And how does it redefine the global balance of power? Settle in, and let's begin this journey together. This is not a tale of abstract machinery. It's a story of ambition, of a nation determined to carve its place among giants. From the coastal plains of the East China Sea to the contested skies of the Indo-Pacific, the HQ-22 is more than a system. It's a symbol. So, what drives its creation? And why does it matter? To us all? Let's step into the past to find out. To grasp the HQ-22, we must rewind to a time when the world was carved into blocks, East versus West, ideology versus ideology. It's the 1970s, and China, still emerging from decades of isolation, relies heavily on Soviet hand-me-downs for its air defenses, systems like the HQ-2, a reverse-engineered copy of the Soviet S-75, guarded its cities against American bombers. But as the Cold War evolved, so did the threats. Stealth technology loomed on the horizon, and China's leaders knew their aging arsenal wouldn't suffice. The seeds of the Hongqi, or Red Flag, series were planted here, in this crucible of necessity. Fast forward to the 1990s. The Soviet Union collapses, and China seizes the moment. The HQ-9 emerges, a system inspired by the Russian S-300, but infused with Chinese innovation. It's a bold step, but not enough. The Gulf War of 1991 broadcasts a stark lesson. Air superiority, backed by precision-guided munitions, can dismantle entire armies in days. Beijing watches, learns, and resolves to build something greater. By the early 2000s, whispers of a new project circulate within the China Aerospace Science and Industry Corporation, CASIC, a powerhouse of military engineering. This project, shrouded in secrecy, would become the HQ-22. The HQ-22 wasn't born in a vacuum. It was forged amid rising tensions, Taiwan's defiance, U.S. naval dominance in the Pacific, and NATO's expanding reach. China needed a system that could do more than defend. It had to deter. Drawing from the HQ-9's foundation, engineers pushed boundaries, longer range, sharper accuracy, and a price tag that wouldn't bankrupt smaller allies. Unveiled in the early 2010s, the HQ-22 stepped into the spotlight at military expos, its sleek launchers and towering missiles a silent promise of power. But its journey wasn't just technical, it was political. Export deals, like the FK-3 variant sold to Serbia, hinted at China's broader ambitions to rival the West, not just in battle, but in the global arms trade. This was no overnight success. Decades of reverse engineering, trial and error, and quiet breakthroughs paved the way. The HQ-22 became a bridge between China's past reliance and its future autonomy, a system that could stand toe-to-toe with the world's best. But what exactly does it bring to the table? Let's dive into the nuts and bolts. Imagine a fortress in the sky, not of stone, but of radar waves, missile trajectories, and split-second decisions. That's the HQ-22. At its heart, this is a surface-to-air missile system, or SAM, designed to neutralize anything that dares invade its domain. Its range? Officially up to 150 kilometers, though some analysts speculate it could stretch to 170 under ideal conditions. Its altitude ceiling? A staggering 27 kilometers, enough to swat high-flying reconnaissance planes or ballistic missiles from the heavens. This isn't just a weapon, it's a net, cast wide and woven tight. Let's start with the missile itself. Picture a cylinder over 6 meters long, weighing nearly 2,300 kilograms, its sleek form belying the destruction it carries. Powered by a solid-fuel rocket motor, it accelerates to speeds exceeding Mach 6, six times the speed of sound, leaving little time for targets to react. Its warhead, likely a high-explosive fragmentation design, is engineered to shred aircraft or detonate near ballistic threats. But raw power isn't enough. The HQ-22's guidance system is its true genius. A blend of inertial navigation for the initial flight, followed by active radar homing that locks onto targets with surgical precision. This versatility sets it apart. Fighter jets darting at supersonic speeds, cruise missiles hugging the terrain, drones swarming in coordinated attacks. The HQ-22 is built to handle them all. A single battery typically includes six launchers, each cradling four missiles, 24 shots ready to fire in a devastating salvo. Add a mobile command post and reload vehicles, and you've got a system that can sustain a fight. Sources suggest a reload time of under 15 minutes, a feat that keeps it in the game when seconds matter most. Now, let's talk about the eyes of the system. It's radar. The HQ-22 likely uses a phased array radar. Think of it as a digital net sweeping the sky. Modeled after the HT-233 radar of the HQ-9, it can track over 100 targets at once, from jets to missiles to tiny drones, while guiding up to 12 missiles simultaneously. This isn't just detection, it's orchestration. The radar's range reportedly exceeds 200 kilometers, giving commanders a wide window to react. And with electronic countermeasures built in, it's designed to shrug off enemy jamming attempts. Though how well it fares against cutting-edge stealth remains a question mark. The HQ-22's architecture is modular too. Batteries can operate independently or link into a larger network, sharing data with satellites, AWACS planes, or even naval radars. This integration is key to China's vision of layered defense, pairing the HQ-22 with shorter-range systems like the HQ-17 or longer-range giants like the HQ-9B. It's a symphony of steel and silicon, conducted in real time. But numbers and specs only tell half the story. To understand its true weight, we need to see it in context, on the global stage. The HQ-22 isn't just a tool, it's a statement. Deployed along China's eastern seaboard, it forms a linchpin in the nation's anti-access area denial strategy, or A2AD. Picture a U.S. carrier strike group steaming toward the Taiwan Strait. Suddenly, they're staring down a 150-kilometer kill zone, bristling with missiles that can strike from land bases or mobile units hidden in the terrain. This isn't just defense. It's a dare, a calculated move to keep adversaries at arm's length. In the South China Sea, where artificial islands sprout missile batteries like thorns, the HQ-22 amplifies China's claim to dominance. It's not alone. Paired with YJ-12 anti-ship missiles and J-20 stealth fighters, it creates a multi-layered shield that complicates any military calculus. For the Pentagon, it's a headache. For regional powers like Japan or India, it's a warning. but its reach extends beyond China's borders. The FK-3 export variant, a slightly downgraded version, landed in Serbia in 2022. A NATO neighbor choosing Chinese tech over Russian or Western options. Why? Cost, capability, and a subtle shift in allegiance. This export success is no fluke. Priced lower than the S-300 or Patriot, some estimate around $30-40 million per battery, the HQ-22 offers cash-strapped nations a ticket to advanced air defense without breaking the bank. Compare that to the S-400's $500 million price tag, or the Patriot's even steeper costs, and China's strategy becomes clear. Flood the market with affordable power. Countries like Pakistan, Myanmar, or even African states could be next, each deal tightening China's web of influence. Yet, its strategic weight isn't without debate. Critics argue it's untested, unlike the S-300, bloodied in Syria, or the Patriot, proven in the Gulf. Could it hold up in a high-intensity conflict against a peer like the U.S.? Would its radar pierce the veil of stealth bombers? These unknowns fuel speculation, but for now, the HQ-22's mere presence shifts the board. It's a deterrent that forces planners to rethink approaches, redraw maps, and reconsider risks. Every system has its shine and its shadows, and the HQ-22 is no exception. Its strengths gleam brightly. A range that rivals top-tier SAMs, a price that undercuts them, and a flexibility that spans aircraft to missiles to drones. It's networked. Design and rapid reloads make it a nightmare for attackers. But peel back the gloss and cracks appear. Stealth technology, like the F-22 or B-2, could test its radar's limits. Electronic warfare, a staple of Western tactics, might jam its TWDE guidance. And without a combat record, its real-world grit remains a gamble. Compare it to rivals. The S-400 boasts a 400-kilometer reach and hypersonic interceptors, while THAAD specializes in ballistic missile defense at altitudes the HQ-22 can't touch. The Patriot, battle-hardened, brings decades of refinement. Yet the HQ-22 counters with cost and scale. China can deploy it in numbers others can't match. It's not the best at any one thing, but it's good enough at everything. A jack of all trades in a specialized world. The future, though, is where the HQ-22's story heats up. Whispers of an HQ-22B swirl, upgraded radars, perhaps even laser-guided, missiles or hypersonic killers. China's engineers aren't resting. They're iterating. As threats like swarm drones or hypersonic weapons proliferate, the HQ-22 will evolve or fade. Its role in exercises, firing drills showcased at Zhuhai air shows, hints at confidence, but only war will write its legacy. For now, it stands as a question mark and a promise, a system poised to shape the skies of tomorrow. As we close this chapter, the HQ-22 looms large, a testament to a nation's rise, a fusion of steel and strategy, a shadow cast across the globe. From its roots in Cold War relics to its reach over contested seas, it embodies China's relentless drive. It's not invincible, not untested, but undeniably pivotal. In a world where air power reigns supreme, the HQ-22 is both guardian and gambit, a red flag waving in the winds of change. What will its future hold? Will it clash with the West's titans or cement China's allies in a new order? The answers lie ahead in the roar of jets and the silence of radar screens. Thank you for joining us on this deep dive into the HQ-22. The sky remains a battlefield, and its story is far from over. If this journey stirred your curiosity, subscribe for more explorations into the machines and minds shaping our world. Until next time, keep looking up.